Hello everybody and welcome to a new series for the Monday. Playing this game, City Skylines. So, first of all, we've got to make our map. But the first thing I'm going to do is show you the mods that I have enabled. So we have a turnaround and say traffic report, quite useful. I'm going to leave a link in the description of what we have, because of course you can click on there and see which one is what is what. So there we go, that pretty much tells us the report of where all the traffic is and everything, which is very good, very useful. Automatic bulldozing when buildings are destroyed, very important. So normally you'd have to bulldoze buildings that's abandoned or got burned down or something like that, and keep the residents happy, but this will automatically do it for us, so we don't have to go around chasing that. We don't have ground level camera enabled because that one always played up. This one, traffic lights remove, I'm gonna turn that off because I've got one that's very similar to that already. So we'll turn that off. We don't have that on. 25 spaces, so you can unlock a much bigger map. So we have that, which you can see on the descriptions. There we go. So we don't have to have a tiny little map. We can have a quite a sizable chunk if we want. We've got like little things like new bridges. So actually improves. So the road bridges normally would do that, and we've made them. It goes more smoother, just so it looks better to the eye, that is. This one, yeah, this one's quite useful. This is a very useful one. You can change the road, you have different road textures, so you can have pedestrianised only, or with cycle route. Yeah, there's pedestrianised only. Nicer bridges. The roads could be slightly different. You can zone them differently. One way road, instead of being two lanes, just be a single lane. But you can also choose, like here, like you could, that could be just turn left lane only, but you could choose what each lane does. So it's very, very useful, and you can make the highways even bigger or smaller. Very useful mod, very, very useful, I tell you that for sure. If you play the game a lot, you'd find that one very useful indeed. Wrong button, there we go. We also have this one. It just gives us multiple track. So we can have bigger stations. Generally all it is. And finally, we have this one, just as useful as the last one. This one is where you could change the, so it looks confusing on that, but generally all you do is you click on the one area and say, like, this lane will only go this way, this lane will only go this way, this lane will only go, it's really useful. And then you can also put the traffic lights, put them. You could take the traffic lights on or off, or you could change the road's priorities, or change the timing on the lights. That's really good, because you could have, like here, they've got is a highway coming up, and you could have this is set at a specific time, and then the next lights up here will set at a time. Now you could set it so when these go green, they all go green, so they can. The traffic will constantly move upwards, and that is really useful. You don't have much traffic jams. You can also pick and choose like what traffic could go down what lane. We could also show, like, if we see lorries coming down a road we don't want them to, so they go through a residential area, we can restrict their movements. Change the speed limits on the road, so you can make roads go much faster than they normally or slower. It's just saying about, like, sorting the AR out. It's still all the different things, so you could. It's showing you where the different ways they do it. See, there we go, you could turn around and, like, this has to give way, this has priority, that's stop, then give. You know, in other words, then this would always keep flowing, and the traffic coming in to this, well, this way would give way. They have to permanently stop before they can go. Like I said, very useful. And another thing it does as well, it doesn't show you on that. You could turn around to say, like, there's a pedestrian crossing, and you don't want pedestrians to cross that road, and you've made a bridge over it. You could stop the pedestrians crossing by clicking a button that says no pedestrian crossing. So it's really, really useful. So that's all the mods I've got installed. There will be a link in the description of all the mods, so don't worry about that. So let's get into making a new game. So let's click new game. So let's go and pick where we want. Now, let's look down through all this. I like the look of that. Connect those two routes, that'd be quite interesting. I quite like the look of that as well. That's not too bad. Not bad. Islands. That's alright. A lot more water on it. I quite like that one. I can see me building like the main city on this bit here, so it jets out a bit like a New York style. So I can see you starting over here or somewhere like that, wherever it starts us. Hopefully not here, and then we'll get the land here and make the get the land here and then just yeah make the main city there. Two rivers, don't. Good, but I don't want it because you can't have shipping container. It's really useful, dude, having all of that, the shipping container. Sandy beach, sand looks nice. We have the coast and lagoon. Sure. I like you could change left hand. You could change how you want. I'd never noticed that. You can actually change how the traffic could go. So we'll change the traffic. We'll have it left-handed, so I know I can. Yeah, it's like being in Britain. Right, let's change the city name. So what should we call it? Let's call it Complete Monday. I think that's pretty much it. So let's go and start. Let's push the button and start. And let's generate a new city for us. This could take a while, so yeah. Oh, it's got a I love the little tips it turns around. Income and outgoing. Is your highway constant a huge traffic jam? Add a roundabout right after it with a road leading straight onto the most popular destination. So pretty much put a spur in. Very good. Some of the tips they give you is quite useful, but you would. It's weird playing this game because you can go around Britain. You can go around any road systems around the world and see why they've done certain things like it is. Because, yeah, that will make it easier to go blah blah blah. You know, from one destination to another, or you've made a spur off the roundabout to make it quicker for the traffic to avoid the roundabout and go a different way, and you know it's really, really useful when you look at it like differently like that. It's funny as anything because just normally you would not think road systems are like that, but they you know they fully are. Everything is planned out. It seems like it's not sometimes if you're sat in traffic, but a lot of times they have been planned out. But you may find that they've been planned out of traffic that was less heavy than what they are now, and then they have to redo the traffic situation today. But yeah, now we're gonna build our lovely city now. I'm just gonna load up when it does. There we go. There we go. We unlocked everything. Because I said, like, I gotta put it as we unlock everything. So we got most of the unique buildings. Some of them we have to do something specialized for it. These are all locked because we've got to build the specific things to unlock them. But there we go. That is that done. So we'll close that. Hello. Let's move away from. Let's get rid of that. Ah, there's that little point I like. So there we go. That's going to be where our main city will be sooner or later. So there's our money situation below. Yes, I know. It keeps annoying me for that, doing that, telling me what to do. So there we go. We got our money situation down below. So the first thing I'm going to do is just make sure we get electricity. And as we have a nice flowing river here, let's find the... That should do us. So that cost a bit of money, but now that'll dam up the water when it gets starting. There you go, starting to dam up the water. That'll start making us electricity, it's getting flooded at the moment, but yeah, it would start giving us electricity. Yeah, okay. It'll start making us electricity. I'm looking at the water pouring over the top. Yeah, that dam's holding that. It's just letting it go over, yeah? 128 megawatts, you know. I dam that at the right place. See, it's just a pinch point, isn't it? So it's... the energy's coming down quicker for this bit. There you go. That's... that done. So, right, next thing to do, let's sort out our residential area. Go away. So here you go, you can see all the different things. We got our lanes, our normal roads. There's a pedestrian rise. These are what you can have, Pacific bus route lanes, which is really good. Go away. Like I said, it does really annoy you after a while, just being in every 10 seconds. Our highways, I should have shown I've also got Pacific highway junctions. Go away. So we can have our Pacific highway junctions, which is really useful. I'm going to do a typical British highway design here. I'm going to put a roundabout just above there, but there. Out to us. Let's get rid of the points. So there we go, we have a roundabout on top. Make that go like that. And that go like that. So there we go. The road goes over the top and underneath. That go like that. The helpful tips get annoying after a while, I'll tell you that for sure. Oh, this could be not a nice junction now. Demolish that, demolish that. See, if you look already, this has cost us money because now we're paying for the road maintenance. So there we go, that'll go like that. And I'm going to put that like that. So there we go. That's our junction. Now, it seems very basic junction, but that's good enough. That'll hold the traffic. That'll get the traffic on and off the road. Go away. Next thing I'm going to do. I love building these avenues. Quite important. Very good. You'll find your people love it when you've put ones like we've. Like now with the trees on it. Go away. Because the trees actually stop the traffic noises so much. So very useful if you turn it around. See, our money situation isn't amazing at the moment, as you can see. I'm going to have it a bit wiggly roads here. So follow the coast there. Shut that down there. Put that like that so it makes up the most of the route. Run that along the motorway. So that goes like that. And shoot that across there. So there we go. We got our pretty much our our housing roughly. Next thing we need to do is we need to pump water. So I'm going to pump it. Normally I try and pump it upstream, but I'm going to pump it downstream here. I'm going to pump it there. Let's put the water pipes in. Might be doing this a little bit quick. If you've never played this game, sorry about that. But there we go. We're just pretty much doing like that. Now we need to put a water treatment plant. I'm going to put that right down here. Furthest away, go away. So like I said, it gets quite annoying, these helpful tips. I wish I knew how to turn that off. Right, so that's that done. And let's go and put the people in. Secondly, let's also make zoned area. So we'll have this, let's complete the zone area. And because I'm going to be making it easier for us at the start. So you just do that. That's all done. Now we're going to set a policy for this. And we're going to set this one. If you look, it turns out it says citizens will prefer working over education, and only a small population of the elite citizens will go to study at the university. So in other words, what it'll do is pretty much they won't need really schools. So you save yourself money from not having to build schools all the time. And that, I tell you, is very, very useful. 144. Power supply, that's really good. Next thing we need to do, we need to put electricity over to there. As they're building along there, let's put the houses like that. I might stick that this side of the wall. There we go, that should give it electricity. So the outgoing will power nicely. There we go, that's got power now. So there we go, since we built houses, we can see now. Yeah, okay. It's telling us how much money we are charging and everything. A lot of it is irrelevant at the moment because we haven't got like specific services involved or anything yet. So, right. It does annoy you, that thing. I wish there was a way to turn it off, actually. I was hoping there'd be a thing there. I'm going to find that out for the next video, I tell you that for sure. Because I can see that really getting on my nerves. Yes, I know you can build canals. Yeah, you can build canals, it sounds weird. Not bad little things to do, putting a canal in. But yeah, it's telling me how I could put a quarry in to finish off the shoreline. So this, do it like that. That. Go underneath for a moment. So that goes like that. So pretty much the traffic will flow onto this new motorway we're building. And I'm going to put this all the way up here. On purpose. This is going up to our industrial area. I'm going to put a roundabout in here. Like I said, I love doing the roundabouts a lot. Um, Like in Britain, we have a lot of that, where a roundabout or above or underneath of a motorway. Go away, you're in my way. And it's a little better for traffic. So there they connect up, go away. I know what I'm doing. There must be a button to say, go away, know what I'm doing, leave me alone. So yeah, that connects up like that. We just need to make connections from this side of the road to it. There we go, that's a bit of a wiggly line to it, but that connects it up. So we've got a feed coming in there, we need to make feeds coming off here. So that'll do nicely there. I'll do. So you got the other feed going straight on there. So there we go, that should filter our traffic through quite nicely. So they got feeds both ways on that. Looks a very complicated junction now, but it'll do what we want it to do, is to keep the traffic going. Next thing to do. Do like that. Go like that. I don't like making it. It looks nice and neat when you make it straight lines, but you'll find I tend to not do straight lines. It looks too uniform. So yeah, that'll do us nicely for our industrial area. As we can see, we need a bit of industrial area now. So let's fill that all the way up. Let's make sure there's nothing that specifically needed in this area. And there's trees here, so we can actually make that into specific area. So we can turn around, click on that, with the tree, and click that. So there we go, we can now make this an area for the trees. For the logging farms and stuff like that. So that's very good. Go away. Let's put the power over to it. And another thing we need to do is put water to it. So yeah, there's water to it. There we go, we can see buildings are actually going in, so that's really good. Now it's moaning that we need a fire service, and we do. But we'll put a small one in now. So that should do us quite nicely, and people will be able to travel downwards. They're moaning about crime in this area, a lot of people getting robbed. So we'll put a police station in. Find a nice place to stick one. Don't like it using up too much space. Could put a big one in, to be honest. And that'd probably take up most of the whole city. Yeah, that brought up pretty much brings it all the way up to the whole city. So that'll do us quite nicely. So there's no good police force. Problem is, bear in mind, our money situation is going downwards now because of that. Fill this all up with houses. And let's go and put our road on the other side, if you can go away. So that go like that, I think. I'd say go like that, and we'll bring that along like this. Yeah, we'll do it like that. Go away! I know I got to put them all in, but I'm trying to put in all the other stuff. It loves just going, oh, you haven't done this. Oh, you haven't done this. And you're like, well, yes, I'll get around to it now, but go away. See? Oh, you should build a fire station. Well, yeah, I have. Go away. So, I mean, it can get very, very annoying quick, this game, with its reminders. So there we go. We'll put that in. And we do need to put a creme in. Because you're going to have people dying left, right and centre on you. And that is done now. Now, next thing we need to do, we need rubbish collection for sure. I haven't forgot that. So that's done. Next thing I need to do, give electricity, but I'm gonna go away. Gonna do that. And hopefully from that, when the buildings come in, that'll give us electricity. Would you bugger off? Yes, okay. Thank you. I've seen. Right. I like using the incinerators the most. For rubbish, and this one's a mod, costs a bit more than the other one, as you can see, but it lowers the noise pollution and air pollution. Some people won't use this, they'll use that, but I use this because I think it's a bit more, it would be more realistic, more fun, quite keeping everything low on pollution and everything. It's telling me that I need to build schools. I've put this as a no school area, so we won't need to build schools here. We'll build schools in the next district, which is right next to it, but this district can be just left as it is, doing quite nicely. There we go, they're building quite nicely along here, so I can put another lot in here. Building more places for people to shop. But yeah, here we go, we can see now the city slowly getting to its point. I might demolish that one day and put a better junction in, but at the moment, as we don't have a lot of money, that will pretty much do for us, because you don't want to spend all your money all at once and then find yourself, oh look, we don't have any more money left. So the best thing is to do is just taper that. Turn around and say we need to build parks, and yeah, I did forget we need to put a park in. Fitting a park in is going to be fun. Oh, I don't know, could fit one in there, because I haven't gone all the way up to the thing. Just go away. So I can't put the bigger one in there. But we'll put that one in there. That will improve happiness, because then people will go, oh, I can go to the park, go for a walk around the park and everything, and that's very, very useful. So you can have all the different ones, and I'm pretty sure that's one of my mods as well. You get a football pitch, very useful. As you can see, you can turn around and put plazas in. That's for when you get into the city centre. These are the mods. You can have basketball court. These are the ones that come with the game, I think. The DLC you can get. Yes, if you notice, there's one inactive. Now go away. And these are the mods I've got. So you can put tennis courts, so it can make it look a bit posher. And of course, we've also got all these different attractions. So you can have piers, you can have turn around. It likes pinging up every 10 seconds. So let's go into the budgets. So now we've turned around. Actually, let's put a bus service running in, because I bet you they're going to be moaning. Yeah, no people coming to work there. So, first things first, that can go away. So we actually upgrade that to that. Now first things first, let's put one of these down. Now you'll find that I'll use buses at the start, and you'll find then I'll slowly stop using buses. The reason is because at points that just they end up clogging your route system up more than anything than helping it. You'll find that it's just the road system gets actually more tedious for having a bus service running in it. And if I could get it on the right side of the road, it'd be a bonus. So if we turn a line like that, we'll make it do a loop. So it goes nicely along there. Bring it over to the commons area. We'll do it like that, just so when we buy the next bit of land, it will loop itself around better. We'll get it go onto the motorway. Can't find a path. I like a photo path. Yeah, there's a path. There's a path all the way there. Okay, it doesn't like doing that, so we'll just make this go around the commons area, maybe. Just do that. So there you go, it just goes pretty much around the areas, just gets businesses there. Now why haven't we got this as a path? Yeah, that is a path. Ah, I see why. No wonder it's moaning about as well as the there we go. Yeah, the rubbish has now been connected, alright? Don't worry. I forgot to put the junction on it. There. Put the power supply back. But don't forget, the incinerator will also make its own power as well. So you'll find that later on that the incinerator will power everything up. Right. I'm going to turn around and get rid of this route. Now, a lot of miserable faces now. I find people are never happy when you get rid of routes. So there we go, I've just got rid of that route. I'll loop it up there, do that, that. Pretty much like I did it before. That. Then we bring it over here because we can now. I haven't failed it again. Do it like that, so it'll loop around later on when we sort out land. Go away. Back there, and we'll come come down here. Actually made a better loop than I did before. So there we go, it goes around the whole area, takes you to the shops, and then takes you on to the industrial area. Yes, okay, I can build a new station. Thank you very much. I know this. We're not near any lines yet. It's pointless turning around and saying, build a station. Isn't it? Like I said, I'm going to find the way, options to get rid of that. I wonder if I can actually do it in-game. Options. Now. Oh, there it is. Hang on. In-game pop-up. Yep. Done. Gone. That stopped it bloody annoying me every 10 seconds. So there you go, now the traffic can go straight on, or go straight down here, go, you know, now we've made it a nice area, these can get workers. And that is what you need then to make money, to get workers, you got to supply the workforce, and make, and just grow the city. It's quite a basic game. Let's just fill it all up now in green, so now it could be all built on, so when people come in they could build all over it. That's been filled up with bluers anyway, so we don't need to build any more, really anything else in there. We're looking at the orange. Orange needs more. So there you go, that gives it more room to grow as well, which is what you need. You need to keep it, just like the city, just keep growing. There we go, we can see how much power that's making. Out 3 megawatts. We can have a look at our power situation. Just click on here. Yes, I've just closed that and it's still coming up with helpful tips. There we go, we only use up 40 megawatts. We make 99 megawatts. Oh, that's gone down then from what it used to be. Oh no, it's still 115 now. It fluctuates because the water will go in and out, in and out. So, of course, you're always keeping the water situation going. So, yeah, that's not too bad. Our water situation, very good. Happiness. As we can see, everyone's quite happy. We don't really have office, so that doesn't... you can see some houses are not too happy. Levels. Just telling you the level situation of it. Wind. So you want to build a house thing. There we go. We can have a look. Healthcare. Doing well. And there's a seaside. So the average health is 71%. If we build more healthcare situations, it will improve. Traffic. Well, it builds up on traffic around here. And that's generally it. You can see it's a few hot spots, but not a lot. Pollution. Here and here. You can tell. Noise. Now we can see these all give out noise, so these residents live quite close to a noisy area because the motorway does give out noise. Fire. We could build another fire station in here, to be honest. Robberies, we can see it's gone. Traffic. You can see 6 per week citizens catch our bus, and that's it. We don't have any of the other services running. We weren't looked at that. We can look at, turn around to say population, so we can see how our population going, and gives us the summary of how they are running. Outside connections, so there we go, we can see how much we import, export, and tourism. That's very useful when you want to see how well we're running. So at the moment we import a lot of stuff, then export. But sooner or later we'll probably turn that around. See, like the forest will export more, but at the moment you can see it's none of it's coloured up because it hasn't been cutting any trees or anything yet. And tourism, well, it doesn't really exist. Money situation, as we can see, the wealth, quite wealthy area by here, and lower wealth around here. Minerals, well, that's how we turned around to see that we could build the trees around here, and like, you could build farms here, oil here, farms here. There's iron ore here, and that kind of gives you an idea and see, like, we're available is 22,790 units per week, and we take 96 units per week. So, you know, we're keeping on top of our unit consumption of that. Our districts, I should add that as district at the top. Leisure, so you can see what how everything going, and of course that is the graphic showing the level of the land. So I forgot to do that, so let's put this in its own district. Quick sketch in, there we go, call the Valley District. You could change the names if you want, so you can click on there and you can just change the name if you want it, so but we'll leave it as it is. So yeah, the next thing I really need to do is make sure we don't lose money. So I'm going to start raising taxes. It's never a popular thing, but that will stop you going bankrupt so quickly. So income, that outgoing is massive. So now we've got to go into the budget, and we can lower a lot of the stuff down. So I'm going to lower the buses down, I always do. As we know, a lot of people are catching the buses. So we'll make it 60% at night, 80% in day. Oh, that's railway, so wrong thing. Be helpful if I looked at the right thing. So let's put that down to 60. That go away. Now I know what I'm doing. So there we go, that should lower our ink outgoing for that. Park, well, to be honest, we shouldn't be paying anything for a park at night. So I'm going to lower that right down to 50%, and I'm going to lower its budget down to 70% in the day. Like lowered to 60%, so that's lower term. So as you can see, our outgoing is going less, and that's what you're trying to do. You got to make an even balance between outgoing and incoming. We'll cut our come in and collect bins at night, so we'll lock that down to 70%. That's chucked down a lot of money in. We'll bring it down to 90% in the day. I try and keep the power and water as high as I can to 100%. You don't want to lose too much on that. We'll bring the crime down to 90, I reckon. Might even bring it down to 80 in the day. So you got better on the police force in the night. Bring that down as well. That could stay 90 because I may have to knock it down a bit more. Put it down to 80. Do it. Next thing, let's knock that down to 80. Well, actually, yeah, we'll have it 80 in the day, and at night we'll knock it quite shockingly down to 70%, and so that is slowly giving us a bit more of a better outcome. Still not as good as we want it, so we can lower the water down now because we have got a very big pump for what it is. Knock it down to 70%. See, the taxes are also giving us money, so you can see our income and our outgoing. Our total is that, so we're losing still £5,000 a year, well, a month, and so we need to recoup that cost somehow. So there we go, we've put it all down to 80%. I'll lower that down to 80 as well. So everything is quite low down. So the next thing to do is really is to put the taxes up still. Hopefully that will cover it. Taxes up rise is very unpopular, I tell you that for sure, for people. But that has lowered it down just 4. Get no income from the other two, so I should stop. I could put it all the way up to 20. We can easily do that. We seem to be a very taxed, hungry place. And from that, knocks it way down to like 3. So it's pretty much paying its way. This is what you want it to do. You need it to pay its way more than anything else. Let's lower that bus service down to 70. So that's just lowered a little bit more. So there we go. We're saving 1,000. We're just out of. We're losing 1,000. 1,600 a month. So that's not too bad. Now, we're still bad. We're losing money, but we're not losing as much as you can see in outgoing and total. See, it's starting to actually even out because we're getting people are moving in anyway. So, and they're paying a higher tax now. So, it will even. I think we're going to be plusing it soon, and that's good because you need to keep making it going a plus to be able to. Get the city working as nice as always. Now these people are complaining because the tax is so high, and they are a bit. Everyone's complaining. So we could give them a tax cut. If we do that, that might ease it. Gives them a little tax cut. Means we're not earning as much money as we were just now, but it gives. The residents' tax cuts, they can't complain saying, oh, it's too high. Oh, where's that doing that? You get is that your money situation just plummets. See, we've got no money now because the taxes are too high, which doesn't help everything. So that don't cost us anything to build stuff like that. So we've got to keep the residents coming in. That's quite important. And we keep the residents coming in, and the money keeps coming in. See, a lot of areas are saying the tax is too high now. Not a lot we can do straight away. We can lower it down to 15. They shouldn't moan so much of that. I am going to lower cost though. And we're already minusing out now. So your bin collection is going to be worse. Your health could be less now. Fire Brigade, we'll knock that down to 16. The police in the day could go all the way down to 60. 17 in the thing. So it's just, I'm going to lower the park all the way down to 50, so we're not paying very little for the park. And a night bus will knock down to 50%, and in the day, it'll go down to 60%. See, that's the thing, we've got to make savings here, and it's very, very hard to make savings when your city is so small. I might actually lower that down to 50 as well. We'll have to do the same for the water, maybe. So they're moaning about the taxes are too high still. Because they're moaning, like, the how much they're paying, value for money, is poor, and it's not that good. But you've got to make money to do stuff, so it's a hard balance, but it's a bit of a pain, but it's one of those things. It's a very hard balance to get everything right, but you've got to do it to make everything right. I could easily turn around, charge them 20 still. So we charge them all 20 again. With the lower thing. There we go. Start making money in the coffers. They'll get really angry about that, but we'll start making money. We can improve our situations. So you can see it's getting very red, very people not happy with the money situation, how much money. And you'll see, like, people will start moving out. We've just minused out again. Yeah, it didn't solve that problem for long, didn't it? See, we put up a more residential area here, but it just seems like no one wants to move into them. Maybe it's because the prices are so... are so high. I don't know. See, like, when I see that, I don't like, normally I play with unlimited money at the start, so this is simple. You work your way through and don't have to worry about, like, prices of everything, and then go into money, so then you just evening everything out. But at the start, you can see it just, yeah, you get bankrupt quick. So I can see this being a fail of the complete series already. Just gonna lower everything down to nothing. Pay the minimum for everything. So even doing that is still more than what we're bringing in. So, yeah. Okay, I can see this being a fail. Right, I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to go read up about a bit of things. I can see us starting this again. Or me mess around with something and then bring back with a bit more money. But there we go. That's it. Sorry about it being a bit of a bloody failure, really, at the start. You can see houses are going. People are not happy at all how much they're paying for tax. I might lower that straight down to the 12%. We don't get much income, but it keeps people happy. I wonder if I can get it up a bit. Hang on. So 15 is too much. 14, is that? City is on the brink of bankruptcy. You must cut services to shut down. Services to shut them down and raise taxes to gain more income. You can also take a loan and we get a bailout fund. That's good. Well, I have knocked down the things, but it just, they, yeah, it's just pain. It isn't like fluid everything down as much as you can. It's just that it doesn't do anything for us at the moment. Bring it all the way there. That was hard work. It's been a bit hard work, this. Now, I want that. That's cool. So, what are you doing with the bailout fund? Oh, well, we're just building more buildings. Problem is, you've got to do that to actually get money back in. It sounds bizarre, but that's what you've got to do. There. And I go into the hub, go into budget. We'll lower that all the way down to 50%. That's not paying us, so we're not paying much for that. Our taxes are quite high end in general. Put that at 15%, so at least it's trying to earn a bit of money in. Hopefully that may improve situations, because more people will move in, they're paying out much higher tax. We can hope, we can only hope. Let's put more resident thing there. So yeah, I'm going to leave it there. Oh, they're not happy with the tax. Might make you happy. Yeah. Not lowered it down too much. So yeah, I'm going to leave it there. They're not happy. They haven't got electricity at the moment because, well, yeah, it doesn't go across a motorway. People don't want to move into these houses here, if I don't know why. They will do soon. So yeah, I'm going to leave it there. I hope you enjoyed that. Sadly to say, it was a bit of a fail at the start, but we'll hopefully improve situations, and that would be very helpful indeed. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to put a little like in the bottom of the video. Put a comment down below if you think I should change certain things to make it run a bit better. But like I said, I hope you've enjoyed that. I hope you'll also join me for Friday for another Train Simulator video. Not too sure which one I'm going to be driving yet. I've been learning the French TGV and also the American route. That's in New York. So yeah, we'll just have to wait and see. But yeah, hopefully you can join me for that. Until next time, bye for now.